going to take just a few moments here to discuss one other way that we can program modifiers into the system, which is using the quick keys down here on the bottom part of the screen. You'll see that we already have the start in shift, we have the no sell, we have the print last receipt, but we can actually add standard items and modifiers and those sorts of things as well as hotkeys down here to call up on the screen at any time from any, no matter which department we're in up on the main selection screen. So let's assume for the example here that we want to add whipped cream topping as a quick modifier that might go on any one of our coffee drinks, might go on a number of items that we sell in the store. Let's click Manager. In order to create that item, the first thing we need to do is go to Administrative and Inventory Maintenance, and let's make the modifier. Let's click Add Item. Here again for modifiers, still remember we're going to click Standard Item to start, and we're going to make sure it's in the modifier department. And we're also going to need to make sure that the modifier item has been checked. We're going to uncheck count this item like we've been doing today. Let's go ahead and create an item number. We'll just call it cream for this example. In the description, we'll call it whipped topping. And let's go ahead and charge a price for this as well. And I think that's all we need to do for the moment. Well, let's click Save. We're not going to create any additional items. And let's exit here. In order to get this item to show up on our quick key screen, we actually have to go to a different place on the back office control panel. We're going to go to number 4, Setup, and we're going to go to Touchscreen Configuration. When we come to this screen, you're going to notice that the orientation here is just like the main screen, and it's going to show us these placeholders for buttons that we can program in. In order to get this modifier attached as a quick key that we can ring up from the main screen here, we need to select this drop down, and we're going to see here just a quickly notice that we have quite a few different functions and things that we can do here to set these quick keys up and use different things. There's a flash report, I see an ID verification, we have weight items that we can use, and recall on hold invoice. But for this time, we're going to pick the fixed item, which is going to get us what we need. Now, it's really important that we remember the item ID, the item number that we created a moment ago, which was cream, because we have to manually key that in exactly as it is in the item number on the item record screen. And then we need to give it a caption as well. In order to get the button to actually show up on the screen, we need to check the display this button box. Or else when we get out of here, we're going to realize it's not showing up. And a quick word while we're talking about this screen. You may run into a situation where you need to configure one station's touchscreen layout different from the others. We have a feature up here called Configure This Station Individually under the Options tab. And if you check that box when we're in this process of setting these up, then this station is going to be set up completely different from all the other stations. If we don't check that box, then all of the workstations that we have are going to reflect the same changes that we're doing right here on this station. Let's click Save and Exit. And let's exit back to the main screen again. Again, as with the other times, we're making a change to a screen button here. It's not going to show up until we log off and log back on real quick. Now our whip topping button is there, and if we go back and order our coffee, and customer wants whip topping, we can just hit that button down here and tag it right on. These quick keys just become really helpful for things that you're selling quite a bit of, and you don't want to have the item nestled down in a department here where you can't quickly get to it.